Hello, this is Naren, Autostat unit with single phase preventer model PFR ASP. So as the name suggests, this product has autostat unit with voltage sensing single phase preventer, both put together in a simple device. So the single phase preventer provided here is of the voltage sensing type. So this will always sense the incoming supply voltage, and whenever the supply in one of the lines is not present, the motor is immediately turned off. Then when it comes to the autostat unit is also called as auto switch. So what it basically does is, as soon as the power supply is back, it will check for the three-phase availability. So if the three-phase supply is fine, it will have a waiting period of around 10 seconds initially. It will monitor the three-phase voltage for the initial 10 seconds. If the three-phase supply voltage is fine, then the motor is switched on automatically. So this product turns on the motor as soon as the three-phase supply is back, and while the motor is running, if one of the phases gets lost, or this is which we call as single phasing, it also turns off the motor. So it acts as the auto start unit and single phase preventer. So that's the hence the name PFR ASP, auto start unit with single phase preventer. So on the device you can see two LEDs. One is the auto start on LED, and one is the preventer on LED. So the preventer on LED is on while the single phase preventer or the three phase supply is fine. When the three phase supply is okay, the preventer on light is continuously on. The auto start on light will turn on only when the motor is only when the auto start unit turns on the motor. That is, it will press and hold the start push button only for 5 seconds interval. Only during that 5 second interval you can see this auto start on light glowing. So for the demonstration purpose, we are making use of LTLK dual starter. So it's the same connection which has to be followed for all similar kinds of starters. So before that, we'll quickly have a look at the wires provided for the connections on Naren PFR ASP. So you will have 3-core red, yellow, blue RYB wire. Then there is one set of 2-core red and yellow wire. And then there is the third set of 2-core red and black wires. So connections wise, if you want to see, you can just have a look at the bottom label. So red, yellow, blue, RYB, the 3-core wires are for the incoming power supply to the incoming supply. Then C1, C2, which is red and yellow, is to be connected in series with the no volt coil or the series with the stop push button. K1, K2, which is red and black, is to be connected parallel to the start push button, parallel or across on push button. So this is the connections that has to be carried out. We'll quickly have a look at how to make these connections. So red, yellow, blue. Before that, the starter connection should already be there. So what you're doing is incoming three-phase supply is going to these three points, the load carrying wires. Then the motor cables are connected to the motor ends, which are these three points. Then the Naren PFR ASP, the first three RYB cables that has to be connected to the same point where the supply gets in, which is we've taken the red, yellow, blue connections to the same three points, R, Y and B. Then we have red and yellow wires which are to be connected in series with the stop push button. So the stop push button for LTLK dual starter is this button, and the terminals for the stop push button are these two small connectors. You might have seen that there will be a small wire which is interconnecting these two points. Small wire connecting these two points. So one will be for the stop push button connector, and the second one will be for the coil. So what you are supposed to do is, you are supposed to take out this wire. You are supposed to take out this wire which is connecting these two. So please make sure the connectors where these two wires are connected. So then after taking this out, you will have to connect the red and yellow wires to the same points where you had taken out those two wires. Meaning, so the wire which we took out were connected between these two points. One was this point and one was this point. So what you need to do is, you will have to connect red and yellow wires to the same two points. So red wire will go to the top point and the yellow wire will go to the coil point. So one will be to the stop push button and one will be to the coil. So it doesn't matter even if this red and yellow wires interchange, but you know, red can even come here and yellow can come here, but please make sure those two wires are connected between these two points. So this is the series with stop push button or the no volt coil connection. Then we are moving ahead to the start push button or the auto start connection, the red and black wires. So this has to be connected in parallel or across start or on push button. So the start button is this one for LTLK dual starter, and the connectors or the terminals for the start are these two. So the auto start or the relay points, which are red and black, has to be connected in parallel to these two points, meaning so you need not disturb any wire which is already there. You will just have to connect these two wires on top of the existing wires. So one wire will go, the black wire is going to the first terminal on the left and the red wire is going to the second terminal on the right. Again, it doesn't matter even if these two wires interchange. So red can even go here and black can come here, but we'll have to make sure that these two wires are placed on top of the existing wires. Okay, this is what we call as parallel connection. So the operation is quite simple. As soon as the power supply is back, you can see the three phase OK light glowing if the three phase supply is fine. Only if the three phase supply is fine, the auto start unit will kick on and it'll wait for a power on delay of 10 seconds. And after this power on delay is done, the motor is turned on. So during the turn on period, the pulse time or the holding time is 5 seconds. So this is a pretty simple operation. We will be powering up now and check the operation. So in order for ASP to function, you will have to turn on the switch provided. So the switch is on and we are powering up the whole circuitry. The supply is being given. So as soon as the supply is there, you can see this preventer on light glowing, three phase OK light. Then after a small delay, the motor turns on. So the delay is around 8-10 seconds. The motor switches on. So the motor turned on due to auto start unit. So while the motor is running, the preventer is always in place. It is constantly monitoring the three-phase supply voltage. Whenever there is a loss of voltage in any one of the lines, whenever any one of the line gets cut, that is when preventer immediately turns off the motor. So I'm turning off the supply in one of the lines now. You can quickly have a look. Just one line has been disconnected and you can see the motor turning off and the preventer light blinking or turning off. You know, this preventer light, it keeps on blinking if one of the line is away, or it immediately switches off the motor. So the disconnected line is again given back. You can see the lights here. The disconnected one of the line was disconnected, which is given back now. As soon as the disconnected line is back, you can see the three phase OK light glowing, and then the auto start kicks in and turns on the motor. The motor switched on. So yeah. So now again I'll be disconnecting the second phase. You can quickly see the operation. Disconnecting, it will immediately switch off the motor and this light will constantly keep blinking. So this is pretty much the operation of Naren PFR ASP. It has an auto start unit to power on the device as soon as the power supply is back. Then it has a single phase voltage sensing preventer to turn off the motor just in case one of the line gets failed. So I hope the video was clear. Any queries, you can reach us out on 9972243774. I repeat, it's 9972243774. You can also browse our website for our other products, and you can even shop this product on our website. Our website address is www.narenelectrics.in. I repeat, it's www.narenelectrics.in. So thanks for watching this video.